Yeah, I'm picking up the vlog here. What's up, guys? Welcome to this episode. I've been pretty deep in my thoughts lately, just because, like, I've had to be, because I've been writing a lot of test scripts and things like that, and about why I'm actually offering VCAS coach and, like, everything. And, like, I was giving the backstory of, like, how like I was used to be skinny fat, as like that's like the term you use is if you're basically really skinny, have no muscle, little to no muscle, and have a higher body fat percentage that like leads you to not look that great aesthetically, and then having like the gynecomastia issues as far as how hormonally how I developed, and also just when I was born having asthma problems and having to be on like doctor to doctor for the first like 3 years of my life. It was always just like, as long as I can remember, the huge insecurity, and I'm writing this story down for my ebook, and I couldn't help but get emotional. Like, even now, just thinking about how shitty it was, it fucking sucked, and I'm putting it very blatantly, but there was so much more that I realized after and what I realize now than what I thought of myself back then and how I valued myself. And if it honestly wasn't for, like, fitness, and, like, this is the first gym that I joined, and then I actually just put my 2 weeks in here to give everything I can to you guys. All my time and all my dedication. If it wasn't for that, I don't know where I would be. And that's not me being dramatic, that's like serious. There was a good, let's see, from junior year to about sophomore year of college, which was only about a year and a half, 2 years ago from this point, I was in a pretty dark spot as far as how I thought and how I viewed myself, and I relied on a lot of outside sources to make me feel better about myself, whether it be drugs or drinking or whatever, or even just withdrawal and avoidance, like just staying inside and avoiding everyone else, because that was easier. And I realized since then, usually the hardest thing to do is the right thing to do. So I think that's why I operate like I have a quote-unquote chip on my shoulder, because of that place that I did come from, and I know that I came from there. Oh, fuck, come on. Yeah. And that's why I had like such big ambition and drive and want the things that I want, and I'm doing the things that I do now and surrounding myself with the positive people, because I know that that's the potential that I have. So if I could help any other person realize that, that would be probably the most fulfilling thing. So I don't know why I wanted to say this now, but I'm going to the gym. I think it's because I have to film a testimonial from a former client. And a lot of times when people come in, they always get the generic reason, I just want to lose weight, but they don't actually get down to the core root, like I just did, of why it matters so much to them to look this way or be this way. And it's usually because it's the hardest thing to admit and to be self-aware of, but 90% of the time, apologies for all the fucking emotion. But anyways, I'm gonna go hit this arm workout, and then we'll get into it. So, thank you all for listening and listening to my rant and vent. Thank you.
Take a few takes. Yeah, we'll take a few takes. Gonna be getting a testimonial from one of my former clients. Sorry for the loud music. For James Bernard. So I'm gonna turn the camera on him right now. He's gonna explain to you a few things that he learned from training with me. So, go ahead.
So, started back in February. My goal was to gain muscle. It was a really slow start because I wasn't sure about, you know, where my foundation was. So what I decided to do from the very beginning is hire a trainer. I worked with Vince from the very beginning. So my ultimate goal was to gain muscle, continue to build my strength up. And right now, I'm pretty satisfied with how far I've come. So with that being said, you know, if you're looking to get into fitness, you know, hire the right training. You know, someone like Vince, he's very knowledgeable. He's very motivational. And when you explain your goal to him, he can get you there. So my advice to you, stay motivated, stay consistent, and be aggressive in what you want, and you achieve every goal that you set out for.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
So what you guys just saw was actually some testimonials by some of my clients that are going to be going into and a lot of the things that I do. All the takes and everything, it's kind of funny. But that's what kind of goes into all of this. So I've been back at my house for a little bit. Sorry about the vacuum. But pretty much, I just ate my first meal. I pretty much did my track workout and my arm workout all in one. I got a lot of people who are going to be interested in the physio revamp program that I'm going to be making. A lot of big stuff, a lot of moves. I don't even think I mentioned, because this is the first vlog that I actually was starting to record this week. So going forward, I am Organifi affiliate. So if you go ahead and go check out Organifi, I'll put like a link and stuff. You can use VCastillo15 at checkout and really get a really good deal on a lot of, I think one of the best, if not the best, green food supplement that's on the market right now. Pretty much green food supplement is just, think of all the veggies you need in a day with all the essential vitamins and minerals that are exclusively from vegetables, you get in one single scoop. And it's actually processed very well, so it doesn't lose any of the actual, the vacuum. It doesn't lose any of the actual vitamins and minerals that people would think as it's processed. It's processed very thoroughly and very highly. So go check it out, save yourself 15%, use VCastillo15 at checkout. Other than that, I'm just gonna knock out some work and then we'll see what the rest of the day takes us. So. Yeah, just a little update. Thank you guys for watching again. I'll see what happens. Peace. All right, so got here to export and I don't even know fucking what time this is. But we first attempted to go to Brick House, which didn't work out. They stopped taking people at 7. That's how I put it on my Instagram. I'm also picking up the vlog late as fuck. It's like 8 o'clock right now. But doing some chest and back. I just ran 13 something miles today, so definitely not gonna do too many legs. Might do leg press after this, but focusing mostly on chest and back with deadlifts. I'm using the trap bar. I'm doing 4 sets, 8 to 10 reps, like relatively light, superset with the pull up, strict form. But yeah, I'm gonna try to record at least one set of it. And also wanna see if my back's gonna twist at all. I got a bad angle there, so I'm gonna have to reset that, but third set of pull-ups pretty much just AMRAP, trying to leave something in the tank. So let's see.
favorite back machines. T-bar machine row. Definitely hitting it up for a horizontal row of the back. And we're gonna do some flies. Probably another, well, at least two leg movements, if not one compound and then something else, but definitely doing this.
Yo, what's up, guys? Coach V here, interrupting this vlog. I hope you guys are enjoying it, and thank you so much for watching. So I'm actually just kind of cut in here on this last leg extension, this last exercise, just to say that, so on this day, I was actually, I didn't have anything planned, but I ended up going out this night for the first time in like a few months, went to this place called the Devereaux, downtown in Chicago. So the vlog is actually just going to see it cut to the next day, but I really hope you guys are enjoying this. Let me know what you want to see as far as with the workout content, if you want me to do more commentary, or if you want to see me do more actual explanation in my content. I'm going to try to get more educational content as far as, besides of just you guys learning from observation of me really going through and explaining the exercises.
All right, so it's the next day. End up going out last night with Happy Fit Bay Boss. And then Lisa, what's the last name?
O'Donnell.
I'll tag it. I don't know. Lisa O'Donnell.
Vegan Lisa Foodie.
Vegan Lisa the Foodie. Is that really what's
her name? Vegan Lisa Foodie.
Vegan Lisa
Foodie.
Oh, okay. I'm tagging both. Whatever. But now we're here doing a functional. I don't know. I'm doing a functional workout because I can't fucking lift. My nervous system will die.
You can't what?
I mean, I'll probably do like some weighted exercises. I ran 13 miles yesterday. I ran 13 miles yesterday, and then I hit legs and a little bit of chest and back. I kind of did everything, so I kind of like fucked myself over for today because I can't really hit anything, which is why I'm doing, look at her fucking last, dude.
I'm gonna do back and legs.
She was inspired by a bodybuilder bartender we met
last night.
Dude, she was swole.
Huge.
Swole as fuck, day. But I'm gonna kill this workout. I might swim some of it, right?
Yeah.
I swim some of it.
So going off of functional strength, going to do some actual, this is actually something that Connor Byrne taught me as like a boxer. So like this one needed to actually get more explosive. So you actually just gonna do push-ups, but you're trying to actually do like boxing push-ups. So you're gonna come up. I use the ball just to hit my inner chest because I still want like some vanity. So I'm gonna use the ball, come up, one-handed, up on the box, pull the box, and then walk down.
Okay, got it. Got it. You lost your ball.
something.
It'll be smoother, but just gotta keep doing it, get the repetitions. That's it.
And don't lose your ball.
And don't lose your ball. Alright, so. Alright. After that, I'm gonna do handstand push-ups on the wall. Everyone's looking at me because I'm recording myself, but I don't give a fuck. Handstand push-ups on the wall. I'm trying 1 foot just to activate my core more when I'm actually coming up. So let's try it. So it's basically taking you guys through the functional. So now I'm gonna be going on chin ups, pull ups, everything else. So chin ups are AMRAP, pull ups are negatives, so you're trying to actually go slow on the eccentric motion. Eccentric meaning the negative when you're coming down. So the chin up, go right in a superset, negative pull ups. So, we can't actually do that many. Like I said, work in progress. I'm trying to improve my actual functionality instead of just like lifting weight. So, that's pretty much everything. For right now, there's 4 exercises. I'm just gonna do as many rounds as possible. Let's just do it. Alright, so I'm adding the last exercise for my serratus because I have a basically shoulder impingement on my left hand side. So because of that, I always have to do a lot of PT and like mobility for it. So what I'm gonna do is actually do some Bosu ball floor rotations, and then from those Bosu ball floor rotations, I'm gonna show you. You basically go up on the ground and you're just rotating your shoulders, making sure you're having your shoulders protracted, so forward, and you're just focusing on the serratus, which attaches to the medial border of the inside scapula or shoulder blade, right? So that's what we're gonna do. Let's go. Thank you. but I'm probably gonna go out and hit some rack rows, just to hit my traps, and then we'll call it a day.
I want to thank you guys for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next episode. Remember to subscribe, hit that notification bell. My brother's hiding in the door. Whatever. Peace.